The meeting sought to facilitate the sharing of ideas among OECS member states with the intention of developing a five-year OECS education reform strategy that will speak to areas in education that may have been overlooked in the past. Authorities are cognizant of the fact that every OECS member state spends a greater percentage of the national budget on education, and as a result, improvements in the field of education are expected.
It is education, not just in school, but a real public education that will make it possible for us to be more resilient, more creative, more entrepreneurial, and more productive. So I want to publicly appeal to and challenge ministers to take seriously the measures outlined in the new OECS education strategy, which was shaped with the widest participation of specialists and educators in the OECS.
The function prompted a call from students who attended for adjustments in the school curriculum to address the development of social skills, for example, self-esteem, self-confidence, and ethics. The students noted that currently no allowances are made for addressing those areas, which are so critical to a successful future life. The youngsters also went on to applaud the introduction of universal education, which affords each child an opportunity to access a secondary education. But at the same time, they lamented the fact that it does not take into account varied student abilities.
It is my hope that the education plan for 2015 to 2020 will have the best interests of us students at heart. And I am proud to be part of the process that will help improve the quality of education that we afford the young people of the OECS. There are many things that I would love to say and explain, but due to time restraints, I will state those of the most important. The education system does not involve students and teachers, but a myriad of stakeholders, including education officials, parents, donor organizations, and even the man on the street.
The students quoted a statement by St. Lucia's Nobel laureate, the late Sir Arthur Lewis, who said that the fundamental cure to poverty is not money, but knowledge. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.